Here we go again. I hate it when Byeonduk makes us feel like we're flying in Cloud 9 and suddenly drops us, like right when we finally get to Cloud 9. It really freaking sucks. Didn't Sungha just promise Nayeom like 10 episodes ago how he won't frighten Nayeom anymore? He looks so happy the beginning of this chapter, then what the F happened? Please don't tell Nayeom he was hallucinating this whole time, or maybe Sungha is just clowning us all. Before we get started, I just want to remind our viewers that if you like seeing more Yaoi content and would like to support this channel, please don't forget to smash that like button. Also, if you haven't done so, please subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell. Feel free to message me in my social media at ZealedForJoshi, which I'll be using to interact with viewers about more Yaoi content. If that's something that interests you, feel free to follow me at ZealedForJoshi. Finally, this episode will contain explicit content and a lot of manhwa spoilers. With that in mind, please proceed with caution. You have been warned. Now, without further ado, let's jump into Chapter 81 of Painter of the Night. I don't know what to say about this chapter. I really do have mixed feelings. Nayeom is absolutely in love with Sungha now. I hate Sungha, but I also love him. And I'm just getting myself ready because I know that the tragic part, it's coming, guys. It's really coming. Anyway, going back to the issue of this chapter, I understand how everyone feels, okay? Or just letting you guys know that you guys are expecting Sungha to change just because he has given love to Nayeom. But it has been quite a while since Sungha has realized his love for Nayeom. Yet, it still didn't stop Sungha from overpowering Nayeom and in the end, forcing him. Right now, he has literally used Nayeom as a tool to release his anger and frustrations. But then again, he was being taken away from Nayeom for a lot of months before this chapter, right? It seems like he is scared that he would unconsciously hurt Nayeom. But still, after months, Nayeom and Sungha came close to one another organically. And that shows in the past couple of chapters. But you have to remember when you see chapter 81 that the Sungha that we see right now, it's not the same as the Sungha from previous chapters that intentionally hurted Nayeom. It's like this is part of his childhood trauma. This is out of his control. The frightened look on Sungha's face says a lot of the things that's in his mind. He is so fucking scared about his dad coming into the picture, that the strong trauma that his dad put him through is really showing. And Nayeom's presence is indeed changing something in Sungha's heart. And we know and we can see that Sungha really is trying to change. And when Nayeom is genuinely falling for Sungha, just like in the beginning of this chapter, like, I know all of you saw Nayeom's face in the beginning of this chapter. And that is him really falling, right? He has really fallen. And even when Sungha walked into the room, Nayeom realized that something is wrong with him. So surely Sungha is in a bad state of mind. And we kind of all wish that Sungha's healing process would finally start, or it probably has started, but he's very far from the end of his whole trauma adventure. And I am really just hoping that they can live peacefully together. But it's gonna be a long, long journey, because that face of Songha in the end of this chapter, that is instant regret from this man. That is the regret face when he realized that he broke his promise. It seems like after a while though, Songha will come to his senses. And I'm pretty sure in the next chapter, he will realize what he has done. Like, the effect of this stress, this whole trauma, not his own will. But anyway, whatever his case is on the next chapter, he will throw some words and just absolutely make fun of some sort. Anyway, regardless though, I know some of you guys will also say that he doesn't have the right to vent his stress or anger to Naeem. I get it, but you have to see it from both of their perspective. I just hope that in chapter 82, Naeem can bring him back to his senses. Because, man, like, we know that there are three enemies heading towards us by the next couple more chapters, and we need Songha and Naeem to fix whatever they need to fix. I would love to see Songha crying and ask for Naeem's forgiveness in chapter 82, very unlikely since he is a lord, but you know, I do hope at least that they talk about their traumas, some little bit of hugging, and a little bit of trust put into Naeem. I would love to see that, but I also know that Byeongdak Nim likes to make us all suffer, so I'm not holding my breath. I hope you enjoyed today's episode. Please don't forget to follow my social media to be teased about some of the boys' love that I'm interested in. Feel free to leave me a message and converse with me in my Discord channel. I'd love to hear back from you. And please consider supporting the show by donating as little as 99 cents through www.zealedfujoshi.xyz. Also, don't forget to support the author. All the manhwa details on how to purchase this amazing series can be found in the description below. Again, thank you so much and hope to see you next time.